Good morning, everybody. I welcome all of you to the online classes of Module 2 in Structural Analysis 2 of 5th semester Civil Engineering. The topic is Moment Distribution Method. This online classes, this e-section of 4. First of all, I thank e-section center for giving me an opportunity for the third time to give online classes. In particular, I thank Dr. C. Ramakrishna Gowda, Professor and HOD of Civil Engineering Department at MIT Mysore, who is VTU E Section of Faculty Advisory Board Member for Department of Civil Engineering. I am Dr. H.S. Nanda, presently working as Professor of Civil Engineering and Principal at Bangalore Technological Institute. Coming to my profile, this is my mobile number 98456 55234, and you can send any queries to my mail ID principal@btibangalore.org. Coming to my academic qualifications, I have completed my BE degree from Civil Engineering from Malnad College of Engineering, Assam, 1986, and M.Tech Civil Engineering from Indian Institute of Technology, Mumbai, 1993. And PhD degree in Civil Engineering from Bangalore University in the year 2007. I started my career after my BE from Malnad College of Engineering and joined as lecturer in Civil Engineering in Malnad College of Engineering. Immediately after completion of my degree, I worked from 1986 to 1988 for 2 years on temporary basis. Then I joined KVG College of Engineering, Sulia, as lecturer in 1988. And I was promoted as Assistant Professor and HOD of Civil Engineering in the year December 1993. And then in 1997, I had a position of Professor and HOD of Civil Engineering. And totally, I worked for 13 years at KVG College of Engineering. Then I joined Nagarjuna College of Engineering as Assistant Professor and Ed in the year 2001 and promoted as Professor and HOD of Civil Engineering in 2005. Then in 2007, In addition to professor and head of civil engineering department, I am given a responsibility to head the institution from 2007. And I worked there up to 2011, totally about 10 years. Then I joined Bangalore Technological Institute as principal in the year 2011, and till date I am working here, and totally about 9+ years experience at BTI. Coming to my small achievements, I have published about 50 technical papers, attended more than 60 seminars, conferences, workshops, and organized more than 70 workshops, including workshops, conferences, and seminars. And I have guided about 40 UG projects and 10 PG projects, assisted and guided 3 PhD candidates. They are all awarded, again from under VTU only. Coming to the membership of professional bodies, I am a life member of Indian Geotechnical Society, life member of Indian Society for Technical Education, and life member of Institution of Engineers. I will be taking online classes of the chapter Moment Distribution Method. Now, the structural analysis, as we know, we deal statically indeterminate structures, wherein it is not possible to analyze the structure just by using equilibrium conditions, that is sigma fx equals 0, sigma fy equals 0, and sigma m is equal to 0. In such cases, that is to analyze statically indeterminate structures, we have different methods. I think you have come across slope deflection method, or you will be coming across Canis method, matrix method, etc. And the one well-known method to analyze statically indeterminate structures is moment distribution method. Here, we will be covering a small introduction about this method, some definition of the terms that we use very frequently in the analysis, and how this method is developed. And based on this procedure or method developed under moment distribution method, we will see how to analyze the continuous beams with and without support yielding or settlement. We also exercise to analyze the orthogonal rigid plane frames, including sway frames, with kinematic indeterminacy less than or equal to three. Coming to the introduction, Moment distribution method is an iterative method of solving an indeterminate structures. This method was developed by or it is introduced by Hardy Cross in 1932. I think you can see the picture also. Moment distribution method is suitable for the analysis of all types of indeterminate beams and rigid frames. It is also called a relaxation method because sometimes we will be relaxing the joints, and it consists of successive approximations using a series of cycles, that is repetitions, each converging towards the final result. It is comparatively easier than our slope deflection method, wherein slope deflection method involves solving number of simultaneous equations with several unknowns, very very complicated sometimes, and chances of going or doing mistakes. But this method does not involve any simultaneous equations. It is very easily remembered. If you know how to relax the joints, or once if you understand the procedure, this method can be remembered very easily. And this method is extremely useful for checking the computer output of highly indeterminate structures. And it is widely used in the analysis of all types of indeterminate beams and rigid frames. The moment distribution method was very popular among engineers, especially design engineers. It is very simple and being used even today with lot of advancement in the technology. This method is used even today for preliminary analysis of small structures. The primary concept used in this method are fixed end moment. That is very important that we do in all other methods, that is slope deflection method and Canis method. And a relative or beam stiffness, or it is also called stiffness factor. And then the continuation, it is the distribution factor depends on the beam stiffness or stiffness factor. After that, another important concept here is balancing and carryover. That is the most important in this method. Calculation of fixed end moment, it flows very similar to slope deflection method. And stiffness factor, it is also you have come across. Distribution factor, that is also it is same as in other method. Only thing, here we do balancing and carry over. If you understand where to balance, how to carry over, this method will be very, very easy. That is why this method will be used by engineers, especially for the preliminary analysis. Whenever any method is designed, some assumptions will be made. Now, assumptions, validity, other things, let us not discuss in depth here. But some three assumptions are made in this moment distribution method. They are, all the joints of the frame are rigid. That is, angle between the members do not change at a joint even after deformation. Connected to this first assumption, the second is also, the joints are assumed to rotate as a whole. For example, if you take this continuous beam, this is the supposed joint in a continuous beam. This is the joint A. B, C. Now, after the application of the load, angle between the members do not change at a joint. In other words, even if it rotates, it will be like this. A. That means AB and BC, they are already in line. They will be, even after the rotation, they are in line with BA and BC. That is, joints are assumed to rotate as a whole, not like this. It will rotate together. Or if you take a frame, rigid frame, because of the rotation, it may be like this. The deviation is too much here. That means these joints AB the angle will remains same. That is here also same, here also same. That is the joints are assumed to rotate as a whole. And because of the loading, there will be development of stresses, and these axial and shear stresses developed are neglected because they are negligible. Now, with these three assumptions, Whichever the method we need for the analysis, especially where loads are involved, sign conventions are very, very important. In general, we use this sign convention now for shear force. If you take the sign convention for forces or loads, as usual, in the application of equilibrium conditions, we take upward forces positive and downward forces negative. Usually, these are sign convention used while applying algebraic sum of the forces, that is sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0. This is while applying sigma fy. If you are applying for sigma fx, the sign convention used generally for forces, rightward forces positive and leftward forces negative. Nothing wrong if you reverse the sign convention, but if you take upward as negative, downward should be taken as positive, opposite nature. But in general, upward forces will be taken as positive, downward forces will be taken as negative. And rightward forces will be taken as positive and leftward forces are taken as negative. Coming to the moment sign convention, first we should be able to decide whether it is a clockwise moment or anti-clockwise moment. If the tendency of the force is to create a moment or turn or rotate the member in such a way that it is in the direction of the rotation of the clock, that is clockwise moment, usually will be taken as positive. And if the tendency of the force or a moment is to rotate the structure in the direction, in the opposite direction of the clock rotation, it will be taken as anti-clockwise moment and it is taken as negative. Usually, this condition will be, or this sign convention is used while applying sigma m about any point is equal to 0. Then coming to rotation. Now rotation, clockwise rotation as like a moment, clockwise rotation is taken as positive and anti-clockwise rotation is taken as negative. Now sinking of support, we deal some problems later after solving some without sinking problems, we'll see. If right support sinks down delta, it will be taken as positive. If the left support sinks down delta, it is taken as negative. In depth, we will discuss that later. Coming to the sign convention of the bending moments. As usual, sagging bending moment will be taken as positive and hugging bending moment will be taken as negative. Now sagging bending moment is the bending moment which will bend the beam if the tendency of the load is to bend the beam in such a way that concavity upward, convexity downward, it is called sagging body moment, and it is taken as usually positive. That is the sign convention used in the calculation of body moments. If the tendency of the load is to bend the beam in such a way that convexity upward and this concavity downward, it is called hogging body moment, and usually it is taken as negative. Coming to the sign convention of shear force. In a beam about any section XX, if you are calculating the shear force by considering left side, upward forces are taken as positive and downward forces are taken as negative. Because we know shear force at any section can be calculated by considering left side or by considering right side. If you consider right side for the calculation, upward forces will be taken as negative, downward forces are taken as positive. That is the sign convention for shear force. Because the sign convention very, very important. Can see here, if upward forces are there, they are taken as positive. Downward forces are there, they are taken as negative. Usually that sign convention is used in sigma fx is equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0. That is equilibrium conditions. While applying sigma m about any point is equal to 0, that is for moments, clockwise moment, that is this type, if they are trying to rotate in the direction of the clock rotation, is taken as positive. Anti-clockwise moment, that is if they are trying to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, they are taken as negative. Rotation, in the same way, clockwise rotation is taken as positive, anti-clockwise rotation is taken as negative. Body moment, sagging body moment is positive, hogging body moment is negative. Similarly, for shear force. Coming to some definitions that we come across in this, it is flexural rigidity of beams. The product of Young's modulus, one of the elastic constant, E, capital E, and moment of inertia that depends upon the section, that is I, is called flexural rigidity of beams. That is E into I product is called flexural rigidity. E will be measured Young's modulus, It is a load per unit area, therefore newton per millimeter square. This E is in newton per millimeter square. Moment of inertia, it is millimeter raised to the power of 4. Therefore, the unit of this flexural rigidity is newton millimeter square. Newton per millimeter square into millimeter raised to the power of 4, it will be newton millimeter square. Now, constant strength beam. If this flexural rigidity is constant over the uniform section, it is called constant strength beam. Then coming to sway. It is the lateral movement of joints in a portal frame. It will be only in the portal frame. Due to the unsymmetrical dimensions or maybe unsymmetrical loading or maybe different moment of inertia or it may be because of end conditions. That is called sway lateral bending. So this sway will occur in portal frames under the following situations. The first one is eccentric or unsymmetrical loading. That is, if you take any frame, the frame may be symmetrical with EI everything, but because of the eccentric loading, it may be a point load with different distances A and B. Or it may be due to this UDL like this, if it is a frame, symmetrical frame, but eccentrical loading. In this case, the portal frame is going to bend like this because loading is more towards the right side. It may bend laterally to the right side. That is due to unsymmetrical loading. Or maybe because of unsymmetrical geometry. If the frame is like this. Or if the frame is like this. Geometry. Depending upon this, this may bend laterally to the left side like this. That is also called sway. Here, because of this, it may bend like this, or anyway, it is called sway. That is unsymmetrical geometry. Now, different end conditions of the columns. Geometrically, they may be fine. But if they are end conditions are different, this is fixed, this is hinged, then also this lateral bending will cause. This is also called sway. And non-uniform Sections. B frame may be geometrically same, but maybe of this bigger section like this, EI here it is EI area, it is EI1, size is different. That is non-uniform section of the frame also may cause the lateral bending to any one side. In such cases also sway will occur. Then unsymmetrical settlement. Frame may be fine with geometry, fine with the flexural rigidity or uniform sections, fine with the end conditions, but because of unsymmetrical settlement of support, if this support settles C to C dash, this is settlement. Then also the frame will bend laterally to the right side, and in such cases also sway will occur. Or it may be the combination of the above cases what we have decided, what we have discussed. That is eccentric or unsymmetrical loading, unsymmetrical geometry, different end conditions of the column, non-uniform section of the members, unsymmetrical settlement of supports, and a combination of the above may lead to the lateral bending, nothing but sway. That is called sway in the portal frame. We know there are different types of end supports. Simple support, roller support, hinged support, fixed support, etc. Now these fixed ends or fixed supports are advantages. Because in fixed support, slope at the ends will be zero. That is, if you take fixed support, the slope will be zero. Because of the loading, if it bends, means initially because of the fixity, rigidity, the beam will not bend here. It will be like this, then it will start bending like this. That means slope here will be zero. That is one advantage of fixed support. Fixed beams are stiffer. If they are fixed rigidly like this, they are stiffer and they are stronger also and more stable than simply supported beam. That is another advantage. Beams are stiffer, stronger, and more stable than any other type of supported beams. Now, in case of fixed beams, fixed end moments will reduce the bending moment in each of the section. Now, because of the fixed end moment, because of the fixedity, a moment will be developing like this. Automatically, any moment nearer to the fixed moments will reduce. Whereas, because of this more bending in other type of supports, bending moment will be more. That is another advantages of fixed supports. Now, the maximum deflection is reduced because they are stiffer. Yeah, they are stiffer. Deflection slope is zero because deflection is zero. And because of that fixedity, this deflection also will reduce. That is one more advantage of the fixed end supports. Now, next is we will have this moment distribution method. Before going to the actual method, I will summarize this moment distribution method. As I told, it is an iterative method of solving indeterminate structures. It is developed by Hardy-Krass in 1932. And this method is suitable for the analysis of all types of indeterminate beams and rigid frames. It is also called relaxation method. We dealt slope deflection method, Canis method, many more methods to solve statically indeterminate structures. Among all these methods, this method is very easier because in slope deflection method, it involves solving of number of simultaneous equations. But here, nothing like that. And this method, as I told, it is simple and it can be remembered very easily. And therefore, for cross-checking the computer output, this method also can be used. And this method can be used for all types of statically indeterminate beams and indeterminate frames. And because of its simplicity and easiness, this moment distribution method is usually used by engineers, especially for preliminary analysis and also for small structures. Now, the primary concept in this method dealing fixed end moments that we do in other methods also, and stiffness factor, distribution factor, and most importantly, balancing and carryover moment. As usual, any method, if it is developed, there are some assumptions or assumptions will be made. Now here, I illustrated with figure also. All joints of the frame are rigid. That is, angle between the members do not change even after the deformation. Joints are assumed to rotate as a whole. The angle between the different members will remain same. Now, directions due to axial and shear stress are neglected because they are very, very small. The sign convention, we have been discussing this from strength of material structure analysis 1 and even in elements of civil engineering. That is, while applying sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, we take upward forces positive, downward forces negative. While applying sigma m is equal to 0, algebraic sum of the moments, we take clockwise moment as positive, anti-clockwise moment as negative. In the calculation of the bending moments, sagging bending moment will be taken as positive and hugging bending moment is taken as negative. Coming to the shear force, left side up, if shear force can be calculated by considering left side or right side, if we are considering left side, upward forces are taken as positive, downward forces are taken as negative. For the calculation of the shear force, if we are dealing right side, then upward forces are taken as negative, downward forces are taken as positive. Some of the definition we use in this method, and we have used this in other methods also. It is flexural rigidity of beams, that is the product of the Young's modulus and moment of inertia, and its unit will be in Newton millimeter square or Newton meter square, kilo Newton millimeter square, kilo Newton meter square, the combination of load and length square unit. Constant strength beam, if the flexural rigidity is constant over the uniform section, it is called a constant strength of a beam. Then coming to sway, it is the lateral movement of the portal frame. Especially in the analysis of the portal frame, before going for the analysis, we should decide whether it is sway frame or non-sway frame. Non-sway frame, even after the loading, or because of different end condition, lateral movement will not be there. Because of the dimensions, unsymmetrical loading or unsymmetrical sections or different end conditions, there may be lateral movement of the joints or the frame. It is called sway. The analysis of non-sway frame and sway frame will be different, because unbalanced sway force also we should include in the sway analysis. We will see that later. Now these are the conditions or situations under which portal frame will bend laterally or will move laterally. Coming to the advantage of the fixed support, we know. Now next, we will deal the moment distribution method procedure. That is a simple method I told.